The Constant Companions Through Escher North, at eschernorthwordpress.com. The Manuscript of Survival, Part 413, April 27, 2014. Mankind has for a very long time harbored great hopes for the future, and even if this hope may seem to be extinguished in a great majority of your fellow men, nothing could be further from the truth. For in each and every single soul on this planet lies that same dormant seed that you have managed to bring into life, and so, within each and every single soul on this planet lies the same possibility to evoke that dream into life. For you are made of the same stuff as the stars, as we have told you over and over again, and so, within your very core lies all of the building blocks you will ever need to make that dream come into fruition. And even if you may think yourself outnumbered in such a way, your dreams have few chances to make it all the way to become reality. It is in fact the opposite that is true. For even if so much of what you see around you seems to be pointing towards a scenario of wars and famine, death and destruction either by mankind's own weapons or by mankind's ignorance and greed, this is merely a small piece of what is truly surrounding you. For what you see is just the surface, and this surface bears so many old scars in addition to all of the recent fractures and lesions, but underneath that surface lies all of the true value that this entire planet holds. For underneath all of these inflicted battle wounds beats a steady and strong heart, filled with love and understanding, ready to be filled with even more light than it has been capable of receiving already. And we are not only referring to every single individual on this planet, we are also referring to everything else that exists here, and indeed, your very own home amongst the stars, your Mother Earth. For this is no longer a place made for dramas being played out in all of their simple-mindedness driven from fear. This is in actual fact a place made for the resurrection of the light, the resurrection of the love that lies there waiting to be rediscovered. For this is what you all brought with you from the very first time you came to be here on these shores, this inner gem, this crystalline form of living light that is contained within your physical frame. But mankind has tried very hard to forget this inner source of light, and it has been trained to forget this inner source of light by beings that held it as their higher truth, that their best interests weighed heavier than mankind's. And so, that inner core of light has been obscured by layer upon layer of soot and grime as you have collectively been pushed further and further into the shadows. But the truth could not be suppressed, nor extinguished, and that is why all of you stand here today, washed clean of so much of all of these obscuring sediments of fear, ready and willing to let that inner light blast out in full force, as you once again stand poised to receive another huge blast of cleansing light. Light that will enable any few remaining grains of dirt to be washed away from the shining surface of that inner you, the resplendent one, the one that has finally allowed itself to be acknowledged, and as such, has allowed itself to fully come out into the light in order to make that inner light fully visible to all. Again, we speak in convoluted terms, but what we are saying is simply this: fear not that mankind has passed a corner that will take them further down into those old dungeons of despair you only know too well from before, for this is not what is taking place now. For even if the so-called leaders of the world seem to be rattling their sabers in a way that has not been done since the last time you lived through a stage entitled the Cold War, you are not about to return to the sins of your fathers. You are in actual fact about to return to the light of your fathers, those forebears of yours that came here in the infancy of your earth, when man was only but a figment of imagination, and all of the rest was the same. For even if those still clinging on to the old once again are raising their voices in fury and in fear, they will not be able to override the vast amount of loving light that is already washing onto your shores, and even if they try all they can, they cannot drown this light no matter how much fear they can manage to drum up both by their actions and by their words. For their powers are feeble, and they can only resort to their age-old weapons, weapons that by now are becoming more and more obsolete as more and more people start to look into their heart and find that glimmer of hope that has always been there. Yes, you will still see many exhibiting the symptoms of still ignoring this call from within, and you will also see many, many signals of the same if you continue to search through that cesspit of so-called information that you are being served each and every second by your media. But if you look elsewhere, if you look into yourself, and if you look into the heart of anyone you might come across, we are more than certain that you will see the real truth there. For therein lies that same glittering crystal of light that lies within all, and even inside the one so filled with fear that it seems to leave room for nothing else is there more than enough space to contain this small container of light, the light that will seem to explode outwards in a huge burst of love as soon as that inner light is allowed to fully connect with all the other light currently existing on this planet. For make no mistake, even if the shadows are clearly visible all around you, they are in fact so because the light quotient has literally skyrocketed during this last short period of time, and as such, the distance from the outside light and into that inner seed of light has never been shorter, no matter what the noises of discontent will try to say. For this distance has shrunk in such a way, it will not take much of an effort to make it disappear altogether, and again, this is all because of you. For you are the ones that started on this journey when the distance to that inner light was as long and arduous and as convoluted as it could possibly be, but you managed to traverse it, through the densest of forest, through the highest of passes, through the driest of deserts and over the iciest of plains, and you made it all the way in. And as you entered that inner sanctum of yours, you also negated that old verdict that mankind would never be able to tear itself away from that inner prison they had created. And as you entered, the thick prison walls around all of your fellow men started to crumble, bit by bit, one grain at a time at first, but as you managed to start to ignite that flame within your heart, these old prison walls became thinner and thinner and everyone else also. For you have reached the source of your hope, and you have found sustenance there, and this in turn has enabled you to open up more and more to these incoming energies in a way that has helped to fuel not only your flight, but everyone else's too. And as you have struggled and toiled to free yourself from all of the old inhibitions, for every binding thread you have severed, you have done so for all of mankind, and for this, we cannot thank you enough. For your struggle has not been just for you, it has been for all, and as such, this solitary journey you have traveled towards your own inner light has brought every single soul on this planet closer to theirs, and now, the distance between them and their light is no more than a heartbeat away. Granted, on the outside it looks as if there are more than enough armored steel, still separating the two, than any missile of light could ever hope to penetrate, but again, that is very much a part of the old illusion. So again we say that you are all pioneers, but as you have ventured where no man has gone before, you have in fact brought all of mankind's hopes and dreams with you, and as you have succeeded in bringing yourself ever closer to the light, you have also succeeded in bringing all of those hopes and dreams ever closer to becoming reality. And now, you are about to bring it all just that much closer. For there is still much work to do, but you have to remember that even if this at times seems to be a lonely and unrewarding journey through the wilderness, it is in actual fact a huge wave of humanity pushing ever closer into tomorrow as you walk side by side, further and further into the light. So even if you feel exhausted and ignored by those around you, and that all of your hard work seems to fall on barren soil, it is not. For as you go about your daily life, you keep on bringing an ever more light, not only into your being, but into this whole world, and now, this light will start to push on even more buttons in those around you, making that separation between the incoming light and that inner, still dormant light less and less. And we would not be surprised if you can already see the results from this sequence of ignition lighting up the light in some unexpected places, and in hearts in all levels of society. For remember, even if someone has been chosen to hold an office that entails having power over other people's lives, it does not mean that this is a heart permanently closed to the light. Far from it, and in this, we are expecting many of you to start to see the truth in the very near future.